Okay, so we're going to do a little fireside chat, and we got something special for you as well. Thank you for being my mentor. Appreciate you.
Thank you, Ricky. You're my mentor, too.
So I tell Karolina all the time, when she plays, she holds people's hearts in her hands when she plays. So if anybody wants to go to Third Street Promenade and see Karolina, you can see her. I want to ask you about really some simple things, okay? I want you to tell me what you've learned from mentors, like Lindsay Sterling or any other mentors. Tell us how important mentorship is and what you've learned.
Mentorship is very important because when you see someone and you like that person, you love what they do, you're like, I want to do something awesome too that inspires others. So Lindsay Sterling, she inspired me to keep going, never give up, and inspire others, because it's like a cycle. People inspire you, you inspire them, you inspire other people, and the world becomes a better place this way.
You're literally the best. Tell me, do you think you have girl power?
I think I do.
Tell me what girl power means to you and why it's so important to everybody.
To me, girl power means when women and girls can stand up and follow their passion. They can motivate others and stand up for what is right. And I think I have girl power because I'm doing what I love. I play violin. And when I see people with their eyes twinkling and they thank me that I made their day, I inspired them, just it helps me grow. And I'm so happy. So that's what girl power to me really means.
So you know I talk a lot about asking for help, right? Tell us why it's so important to ask for help in anything that you do.
Because where do you get the answers? if you have answers, you can go to a person and ask them, and they'll help you.
Is it okay to ask for help?
Of course it is, guys. Don't keep it inside. Ask for help.
Does asking for help come from strength or weakness?
From strength.
Why?
Because you're strong and brave to ask for help. You're not sitting in a corner and being scared.
Would you rather try something and fail or never have tried at all?
I'd rather try and fail than never try, because if you never try, you never know what's going to happen. So, yeah.
You have a pretty big following on social media, huh?
Yeah.
How many on YouTube?
On YouTube, almost 8 million.
8 million?
Yeah.
Yeah. Give her a round of applause. Did your dad speak English when he came to the United States?
No, we didn't know any English. It was so new. It was like stepping into, with your blindfold onto a beam, like 1,000 feet high.
Great analogy. Do you want to say something in Russian in case anybody speaks Russian? Say whatever you want.
Привет, друзья. Меня зовут Каролина Протенко, и я очень рада, что могу сегодня для вас выступать. И хочу вам сказать, что никогда не сдавайтесь. Идите вперед, достигайте своих мечты. Да, достигайте свои мечты и будьте светом в этом мире. Спасибо.
Yes. Yes. Okay, and so, you know, you've been on some pretty big platforms. You've been on Ellen DeGeneres. You recently won on Kelly Clarkson, right? Mm-hmm. Tell me about that experience, and did you like it?
It was like a dream. It was so magical because I got to meet Lindsay Sterling, and she was the first person that inspired me to dance with the violin. I love her so much, how she moves, her costumes, her hair. She's such a nice person and generous person. She gave me one of her violins with her logo, and it was so cool. When I was performing with her, it's just the best feeling when you can perform with someone who inspired you once, you know, and it was just so heartwarming. I'll never forget that moment for the rest of my life.
Nice. I love that. So, right? Don't you want to clap for her all the time? I do. So I share with you, with everybody, everybody. And so another brain hack that I'm sharing with people is when things don't go good for me, I go to you and I watch your videos and I listen to all the content that we have. I even have an album of you on our phone, on my phone.
Aw, thank you.
So when I'm having a tough time, I literally think of Karolina and I think of her going after her goals and dreams. And it makes me forget my problems and go after my goals and dreams. Because if she's that powerful at this age and inspiring that many people, that's all I gotta know. And now I can keep traveling towards my goals and dreams because you have inspired me. Thank you.
Thank you so much, everyone.
Asking for help, it's a common theme. And there's something that happened that was so awesome. I was at Compass. We got any Compass people here? Wow. Wow. So Compass is a real estate brokerage. And I went to speak to share the event, and a lot of people from Compass came. I got a call after that event. Is Melissa in the room? Is Melissa in the room? So Melissa's right there. Melissa was at one of my first talks that Mike Aronsky got me. Where's Mike? Where's Mike? Where's Mike? Love you, buddy, if he's in the room. If he's not, love you anyway. So somebody asked Melissa to be connected to me, and it was because her young daughter that's 10 years old asked for help. And I want to give so much credit to this because it's not easy to say, well, I want to talk to somebody outside of my family, which I think is insanely valuable. Women empowerment, it's something that we're fighting for because sometimes we had to go outside of our family unit to get help, and that's okay. That also comes from strength. So she called me up. And she was like, hey, can you kind of chat with my daughter? I was like, yeah, 100%. So I went down with Kim Donner and Sydney Donner and Hazel and Woody from Compass, and we had an awesome day. But I said, look, I'm happy to help you, but I think there's other people that can help too. And I thought of you. So what I want to do is express the gratitude and the power of asking for help from women to more women. So we got a little surprise for you. I want you to come upstage, yep, and let's give Sydney Donner a round of applause. And we actually need another mic. Is there another mic? Actually, you guys can share this. So here's a mic. Do you have a question for Karolina? There you go. Oh, there you go. And we got the other mic. So Sydney has a couple of questions. I want to say that is awesome. You are strong and powerful for doing what you did. Okay? Do you like her shirt? Yeah. That's a good shot. Somebody get a picture. Okay, go ahead.
How many hours in all do you think you've practiced?
I think that is such a hard question because I practice every day for about 2 hours. I think in my whole life, maybe, definitely more than 10,000.
Okay.
So more than 10,000. So that maybe 30,000 hours.
And what or who are you grateful for?
I'm grateful for everything because honestly, you can be grateful for everything. But the most important things that I'm grateful for and people are my family, my dad and my mom. They're so amazing. They help me grow each day. They guide my footsteps and I love them so much. And I'm grateful for my little brothers.
Do you have another question, Sydney?
You said it.
So we good? No. Okay. So give Sydney a round of applause. Stay there. Stay there. Stay there. Awesome. Okay. So stay here. All right. I want to bring up more badass women. Can all you guys come up here for a second? And I want to talk about women mentorship. All right. So thank you for being here. We're kind of just improvising here. Give me about 30 seconds on women mentorship and power, and let's just pass it on. 30 seconds, 30 seconds, 30 seconds, 30 seconds.
Okay, hey guys, I'm back. They're like, oh God, is she gonna blow my brains out again? Okay, so Women empowerment, female mentorship, what is it? Are we talking only about female mentorship or just mentorship?
Anything.
Okay,
female,
so
female.
I mentor a lot of men, so I'm just going to go for like the whole being a woman and being somebody that preaches into the souls of people. I truly believe that sometimes somebody can tell you something, but then somebody else says it to you. And because it's come from a woman, it just kind of hits different. It just kind of resonates in your field. Women have a way of being able to talk to your soul. We have a way, and I wish I had a mentor who was a female. I wish that my mentor had have been a female. So when people say, Natasha, who do you look up to? I don't have that person that I looked up to. I look up to Oprah, and I love her stuff, Michelle Obama, but I don't have somebody in my lane who did it, so that's why I do it, for the people who want to be inspired. So if I can inspire you today, like, you know, you've inspired you, and Lindsay inspired you, the same thing, that inspires you to then go and affect your audience, affect your community. So that's why I think the power of mentorship is very powerful. Thank you.
There you go, Mary.
Nice wing in this. Yeah. honestly, I am only where I am today because of mentors. Jason has been one. When I first got into real estate, as I mentioned before, Jason has been a godsend to me. And everybody needs somebody to look up to. I think women need to support women. There's just that we all need to help each other out, look up to somebody. And my good friend Natasha now, she is my mentor. I just think it's very important. We can all help each other in one way or another. So I think, I think that's
awesome.
Was that good enough?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Brit women power.
Can we just take a moment and look at all of these beautiful women on stage of all ages that do all different things? Like, I'm an acrobat, she's an acrobat, they sell houses, she's a violinist, and you're a gymnast, right? And everyone here does, everyone here does something different. And we all came together to this event to inspire you guys to be yourself, wake up every day, do something that sets your soul on fire. Like, wake up, get out there, do something you're passionate about, because tomorrow's never promised, and you really want to make the best of your life, so that's awesome.
Brit. Before you go, so Carly was told she's too old to do X, Y, and Z. Carly was told she shouldn't do X, Y, and Z. Carly asked Brit to be connected to me because she wanted to get outside of her network. She wanted to
start on Friday, just this past Friday.
On Friday. She wanted.
I live in Tennessee.
She lives in Tennessee. She wanted to get outside of her network and start expanding her network. But her network that was garbage said, you can't do that. You're too old. You can't. You got kids. You're a single mom. Blah, 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 blah. We chatted for half an hour. Said, you can come. There's going to be some badass people. She bought her flight. Round of applause. That is what this room is about. Is expanding and being around empowered people and positive people day in and day out to change the trajectory of your life. So when you see Carly, that needs to be honored and commended and supported. So thank you. Here we go.
Thank you, Ricky. I just want to say, I'm 39 years old. It took me 39 years to love myself, to love who I am. Do you know where I was last night? I was at home with my daughter, my 15-year-old daughter, who was sad. Because quite often she's bullied at school because they're not taught mentorship. They're not taught gratitude. And you know what? I was in such a bad place for so long that I was not the example for her. Sadly, I was not that person for her. I couldn't show up in the way I wanted to. And so last night, now that I do love myself, I can show up differently for her. And I do show up differently for her. So last night, I held her and I was hugging my daughter last night and just sharing love, gratitude, and joy with her. And today I am here and I videoed, tell me your name, say it one more time, Karolina. I videoed Karolina so that I could show, my daughter's name is Carmen. Carmen, what children can do. It doesn't matter the age, how old you are. You can inspire people. You can grow. You can learn. It doesn't matter if you're 5, if you're 39, doesn't matter. There's always room to grow, to become better, and to love yourself more.
And she's going to be speaking at our next event. All right. So can I get some Good Day Oz? They're going to do a little trick, and then we're going to go to lunch. I got a couple announcements before we go to lunch. But you, everybody stay up here. Let's just check that Oz if you can give us some Good Day. And thank you, Karolina. And thank you, Sydney.
I woke up this morning.
Let's get a clap.
And I said, you know, instead of waiting for a good day to happen, you know, waiting around through ups and downs, you know, I just said, look.
We're gonna have a good day, and all my homies gonna ride today, and all these homies look right today.
Yeah.